Many now wondering whether this is the first sign that the military is starting to fray, and certainly opponents of president or dictator, depending on your perspective, Nicolas Maduro, hope so. However, Maduro insists this was just a small renegade band, and he calls them terrorists as well. The group of 20, according to the government, launched an attack on a major army base in the city of Valencia, and that sparked a short gun battle, leaving two of the rebels dead, one injured, seven captured, and 10 others fled into hiding. President Maduro says a manhunt for those 10, which he also calls mercenaries, is now on full speed. In his weekly television address, Maduro vowed the rebels will be captured and will suffer the maximum punishment, adding there's no leniency for deserters. He said the, quote, glorious 41st Brigade immediately put down the rebels, who Maduro said hoped to start a civil war but failed. Maduro says the group of 20 were not active duty military, but mostly civilians and deserters. On Saturday, the new National Constituent Assembly fired Venezuela's top prosecutor, who was viewed as a threat to the Bolivarian Revolution. The two prominent opposition leaders, who were arrested and hauled away from their homes last week, well, they have now been sent back home, but they remain under house arrest. And Friday, the National Constituent Assembly convened for the very first time, which is all-powerful and answers to no one. Meanwhile, the opposition-dominated National Assembly still refuses to recognize that body, saying it further cements Maduro's dictatorial power and plans to have its own gathering today. Daily clashes, of course, between protesters of the government and the government have been happening pretty much for the past 4 months, leaving more than 100 protesters dead in a country that has a horrible economy and, of course, persistent food shortages. Leland?
Yeah, seems to continue to get worse there. Phil Keating in Miami. Phil, thanks.